Yo, what's going on, guys? Bobby here, and today we are back with another video. So today the new balance changes came out and they have gone live, and it has pretty much shaken up the meta a good amount. Now, some of the brawlers did remain exactly the same that were very OP. Some of them got a little bit of a nerf. You're looking at one on the screen right now in Poco. And some brawlers got a lot better. So we're going to do what we usually do, cover the top 10, show you guys a new meta, the new balance. With that being said, let's hop into it and let's show you guys what's up. So coming in at number 10, we have Sprout. Now, Sprout, as you guys know, has been a very good brawler for a very, very long time. Almost a year now, I want to say. But it has fallen off a little bit than what it used to be. It's not nearly the best brawler in the game. In fact, number 10 is even pushing it a little bit. The only reason it should be number 10 or even in the top 10 is because of the fact that it counters a lot of things. About half the brawlers in the game, Sprout really, really hard counters. And it's not like Sprout, you can really counter too much unless you're playing like a tank or a speed BB or a Mortis, because it can just hide behind walls, chill, and it's not that easy to get a kill off of. The gadgets got nerfed though, the shot got nerfed, and it's not as good as it used to be, so we're going to place it at number 10, the borderline top 10. Let's hop into number 9 and show you guys what it is. Now coming in at number 9, we have Crow. Now Crow is a very, very good brawler, but it's kind of a sneaky good brawler. It's not a brawler that's going to necessarily carry your game or be your main DPS, be the body block, make the game-changing play, but its gadget is the reason why it's going to be in the top 10. Now remember, this is just 3v3 only. We're not factoring in duo showdown, showdown, takedown, lone star. I don't even know if that's still in the game, but we're not factoring that at all. The Crow slow is one of the most lethal things in the game. I want to compare it to something like a Gene pole or a Tara pole, where once you use it, it basically just means insta death. You stand still, I think it's for 5 whole seconds, and you don't necessarily stand still, but you're slowed to a point where you can just get auto aimed right to the face. And it's just a really lethal brawler to go up against if matched with good brawlers. So again, it's not going to necessarily just snipe you like Piper, do high DPS like a Shelly or a Colt, but you're going to slowly chip away at your lane, slowly win kind of like a Sprout, and then you have that one lethal play where you can just slow everyone, and as you guys can see, it's just free pokes for us. They can't really do anything about it, and that is why Crow is going to be our number 9 brawler. Coming in at number 8, we have Poco. Now, Poco was arguably the best brawler in the last meta, so it's a little bit of a fall off for Poco. Not much got nerfed, just takes one more shot to charge your super. Four, rather than four. Not a huge deal when it comes to healing. Poco still is really good at actually doing its job, which is healing. But Screech isn't as good as it was before. I almost get a really nice goal here with the pass to myself, but I messed up the timing a little bit. But anyways, that's not the point. Poco is just not as good as it used to be with the Screech side. Again, it's really good with the heals. That's why we're going to leave it at number 8. It could arguably be higher. Could be 5, 6, 7, maybe even 4. But I'm going to place it at number 8 because I find a lot of the other brawlers really well-rounded and good basically everywhere. As for Poco, I think it's going to go back to what it used to be before, where it was really good with tank comps. It was really good as a heal, not really as an aggro very much anymore. And that is why we're going to leave this at number 8. And let's skip on to number 7 because there's really not that much to talk about with Poco. Let's get into it and show you guys what's up. So coming in at number 7, we have Amber. Now, Amber is a really well-rounded brawler. It's kind of really good everywhere, and it was obviously the best brawler in the game not too long ago. They gave it a little bit of a nerf, and it really fell off. Not a lot of people were using it, but now it's slowly starting to creep back in the meta. It was already kind of a good substitution instead of the Sandy and the Max Gene comps. You can instead use Amber instead of Sandy, and it was really starting to catch on. A lot of people were starting to use it, but now even more so with Sandy getting a nerf, do I think Amber is going to shine in this meta? It's really well rounded, doesn't really get countered by anything. I mean, Mortis is good into it and Stu is good into it, same with Surge, but it doesn't really get hard countered by anything like Mortis in, or like Dinah into Mortis or anything like that. It's pretty well rounded, so it's pretty easy to use just about everywhere. Definitely usable and goes really well and synergizes really well with a lot of other comps. This is why it's going to be number 7. Again, I like well-rounded brawlers, and I think it's well-rounded brawlers are just pretty useful. You can use it anywhere. It can go aggro on hot zone, can play defense in hot zone, can be mid, can be, you know, attack on brawl ball, etc. It's just a really good brawler. Good on defense and siege, good on attack. It's just really well-rounded, doesn't really lack in anything. So this is going to be our number 7. Let's hop over into number 6, and this is where the brawlers start to really get really good. So let's hop into number 6, and let's show you guys what the top 6 most elite brawler in Brawl Stars is. So coming in at number 6, we have Max. Now, as you guys know, from every single time I make this list, which Max has been in every single time, I state that I'm not a good max. You guys aren't going to see good max gameplay from me. I'm not going to do any max tutorials or anything like that because I'm just not good at max myself. So I don't really want to teach you guys something that I'm not really good at. But Max is a very good brawler, not only because itself as a brawler is really good, but because of the synergy it gives other brawlers. If you guys watch competitive Brawl Stars or anything like that, you guys will see Max is used in just about every single comp that it can be used. It's just really good everywhere, has really good synergy with brawlers like Jean, Sandy, Amber, Tara, Stu, just basically any brawler that's really strong and you can give speed to make stronger. It just makes it so OP. It has probably the best synergy in the game with other brawlers, and it's just really well-rounded. When it has the Ruff's power-up as well, it's also very strong. It's basically the best brawler in the game, I think, with the power-up, because you have good DPS, good health, good speed, good super, good gadgets, just good everything. It's probably just the best brawler in the game, period, with the Ruff's power-up. But with that being said, we're going to now move into the top 5, and these top 5 are the elite of the elite. These are just extremely strong brawlers that are just pretty much broken. So let's hop into the top 5 and let's show you guys what it is. So coming in at number 5, now this one might actually be a surprise for you guys, but we have BB. Now BB, I feel like, always goes up and down on the meta tier list. Not necessarily because it gets changed all the time, but because I think with BB, it's really, really dependent on what is meta at the time. So with our meta changing and it being what it is right now, BB is really strong into the meta. Now one brawler that's going to be in the top 5, now this isn't really a spoil, so I'm just going to say it, Stu goes really well into BB. So if Stu didn't exist, I think BB would be much higher up on this and be really elite, but you know, Stu is really good, so it's not going to be that high because you're going to end up facing a Stu a lot of the time. But with the way this meta currently is, BB is extremely strong and a very, very good brawler. Now, Shield BB is not as good. They gave that one a nerf as it was really broken a couple months ago. But now Speed BB is the broken star power with BB. I would highly, highly, highly recommend practicing BB because it's actually a really good brawler, really strong, really versatile in a lot of different modes. And it's not too hard of a brawler to pick up. So this is going to be our number 5. Let's move into the top 4 and show you guys what it is. So coming in at number 4, we have Barley. Now, Barley was arguably the best brawler in the last meta. And it could honestly be argued for top 3 here, but I'm going to keep it at number 4. Reason is because I believe a lot of the brawlers that are now in the meta just counter Barley really well. Now, if you play Barley correctly, you could do well against them. But for example, one of the brawlers that got a buff, Carl, you guys are going to see over here, can just flying hook right towards me, and I can't really do anything about it. Or like an Edgar can jump on me, and I can't really do anything about it. And there's just a lot of brawlers like that where I just necessarily can't really do anything about as a Barley. If they do something to me, I'm screwed, I'm clapped, there's no way I can get the win. But at the same time, Barley is easily the best thrower in the game. It has been for about a month and a bit now when it overtook Sprout. It's really good for control. Both gadgets are really good depending on how you want to play. Both star powers are really good depending on how you want to play. So it's just a really strong brawler. It did lose some range, but I don't think the range was necessarily what made it absolutely broken. So it's going to stay at number 4 and fall from either 1 or 2, whatever it was before. So let's hop into our top 3 now and show you guys what it is. So coming in at number 3, we have Belle. Now Belle, again, could have arguably been the best brawler in the last meta up there with Barley. It was either Belle or Barley, but both of them were really OP. And both of them took a little bit of a hit to the point where, you know, they're still top 3 or 4 brawlers. And we usually see this with brawlers that, you know, are really OP, is that they don't just get nerfed to the absolute ground. What actually happens is they get nerfed a little bit and then get nerfed a little bit again, and then they slowly start to become a little bit more irrelevant. That's the case with kind of most of the OP brawlers I've noticed nowadays, so it's probably going to be a theme we see with Belle. They just nerfed her range a little bit. She used to have the longest range in the game. Now it's the same as, I believe, Brock, Piper, and... what is it? Brock, Piper, and Byron, I think. I think it just has the most range tied with them instead of just the most range now. But it's still a really good brawler. It's still super annoying in, like, Siege or Heist when you're trying to, like, defend a Heist safe or defend a bot. And the Bell shot is bouncing off the Ike, bouncing off of you, bouncing back to the Ike, just getting a lot of value. And then on top of that, the range, the damage, all of that is just absolutely killer. So we're going to keep Bell at number 3, and it's going to stay in our top 3 for today, but I can see it falling out of the meta pretty soon. I don't think it's going to last very long in the meta because it doesn't seem like long range brawlers really do nowadays, but I guess we're going to see what happens. So let's hop into the top 2 and show you guys the by far 2 best brawlers in Brawl Stars. So coming in at number 2, we have Stu. Now Stu is really good now, and Stu is one of those brawlers where it was kind of the same. In fact, it was stronger, before than it was now. But now that people have really learned how to play Stu and really adapted to Stu, it is such a good brawler. It is so good. I think people are still learning how to kind of counter it and how to face it. But it's just such a strong brawler. It's so annoying. When you face something that you counter, there's just no way for them to beat you if you play it properly. It's totally dependent on if you mess up, not on if they play good. It's just such a strong brawler. And you guys can see here, I'm just being such a menace. The Gasaheal star power is just extremely strong, keeps you alive for so long. The only issue is that sometimes you can run out of shots with Stu because you're just chaining so many shots, so many supers that you can run out, but it's not usually too much of an issue. But yeah, Stu is just absolutely broken. Would highly recommend becoming good at Stu. I'm not really that good at Stu. I'm kind of practicing, but it is a broken brawler and I would highly recommend practicing. So let's now hop into the number one that just absolutely flew its way up the meta. Literally went from like bottom 10 to number one in one day. Let's show you guys what it is. Let's hop into it. So coming in at number one, we have Carl. And this is one that I am super happy about because when Carl was meta about 6 months ago, back when it was World Cup finals days, I was just learning how to play Carl. It was never a brawler I played. Having Alec on the team, being the GOAT 2K Carl, he was always the Carl, but as the meta kind of changed and he was playing different brawlers, I started to learn Carl, and literally in like the last week that Carl was the best brawler in the game, or one of the best brawlers in the game, they nerfed Carl, and I was so sad because I was starting to become such a good Carl. But here it is, back again. The Carl is the most meta brawler in the game once again. The flying hook is ridiculous now because of the speed of the shot is faster. The flying hook is also faster. It has 1/3 of a tile less range than it did when it was meta, but the shot speed is faster, so it kind of doesn't really matter. It's just really lethal. It's such an absolute good brawler. You can have two different playstyles with the shield, and with the fast attack. It's just so, so good. Doesn't really get countered by anything. It's really good into all throwers because you can just flying hook or super up into them. Good against tanks because you can kind of just keep your distance. And really good against mid-range as you can kind of just poke from a little bit further than they can reach. But it's just a really good brawler, really good in a lot of modes. The issue is its DPS isn't really that high, so you're not going to destroy a safe or destroy a bot necessarily with Carl. That's really its only downfall. But it's an extremely good brawler, and I would highly recommend playing this on ladder or getting it to like 1k trophies if 1k is something that you guys want to do with any brawler. Carl is definitely the one I would recommend. But anyways, that is going to be it for the top 10. If I can give some honorable mentions, I want to give one to Sandy because Sandy's a really good brawler. Ruffs, because Ruffs, if you are a good Ruffs and if you can win your lane with Ruffs and then give power-ups to your teammates, there's basically no chance you can lose. And then Rosa is also a really good brawler, I feel, but it just isn't in, it's necessarily, it's just not the best meta for Rosa right now. If other brawlers were good, Rosa could be better, but as it stands right now, Rosa just isn't the meta. And then Jean is starting to slowly creep back into the meta. I hope we get a tiny little buff with Jean because that would make it just super meta again. And, you know, we all love when Jean is super meta. But that is going to be it for the video. Thank you guys for watching. If you guys enjoyed, leave a thumbs up, subscribe, all that. Back-to-back days with videos. You guys should be proud of me, but that is going to be it. I will see you guys tomorrow. Peace.